Hello everyone, welcome back to our channel. Today we are going to discuss about how to do the concurrent force experiment. What is the aim of this experiment? With the help of this, we can verify the triangular, we can verify the parallelogram, and we can find out the volume and density of the given stone. So first of all, we have to verify the parallelogram. For that, what are the apparatus? Here, this is the one stand is there, two pulleys arrangement is there. Then this is having the three weights are there. Each strip is representing 50 grams. So here P is having 50 plus 50, 100 grams, and Q is also having 100 grams, and this R is having the 100 grams. Then we can take out one A4 size papers or given question paper, and we should paste to the drawing board like this. With the help of the drawing board pins, we will attach like this one. Then we can observe the shade of this Y shape. So this is representing here, these two are representing two adjacent sides of the parallelogram. So P is one side, 100 grams, and Q is one side, then R is representing the resultant of these two. So these two are representing two adjacent sides of the parallelogram. This is one adjacent side and this is another side, and first here we know that one side is P bar, another one is the Q bar, diagonal. This is representing the diagonal of this one. How to trace out later I will show to you. First of all, how to start this experiment. So after attaching this plain paper, with the help of the pencil, we have to observe the shade. Look here, this equilibrium position shade, where it is, we have to put one point. This is one dot. Then along the Q, then along the P bar, where is the shade, we have to draw this thing. And along the R, where is the shade, just you have to take the two points. Once again, I'm repeating, after taking P 100 grams, Q 100 grams, and resultant is the 100 grams, we can observe the Y shape. We have to trace out the Y shape. For this, we are taking the two dots, just shade of this P bar, two dots, and shade of this Q bar, two dots we are taking, and along the R bar also two dots, and this is representing equilibrium position. So then we should write it. This here, P value is 100 grams, Q equals to 100 grams, then R equals to 100 grams. This we can go for 150 grams, means each side we have to attach 50 grams here. Now P value is 150 grams, then Q value is also 150 grams, and this is the R value 150 grams. Same, we should trace out the Y shape. How to trace out the Y shape based on this shape? And we can, some people they are using the light also for this shape. See, we can observe the, this is the Q value is 150 grams, R value is 150 grams, and P value is also 150 grams. See, this is the equilibrium position. We put one, and along the P we have to take two dots, and along the R also we can take two dots, and along the Q also this one. But here we can repeat, this is P value is P equals to Q equals to R equals to 150 grams. 150 grams. So like that, we should repeat this experiment for one more reading. We are repeating this experiment for 200 grams. So P value, Q value, R value, we are taking each side is the 4 strips. See, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 200 grams, and this is R is the 200 grams, and this is also Q, we are taking same weight. This is the 200 grams. So first one is for 100 grams, second one is for 150 grams, and third one is for 200 grams. All these three we are taking for the verification of triangular and parallelogram. And don't forget to take the trace out the Y shape. For this, here also along the P side we are taking two dots, and along I am using the marker for showing this one, but we are using the pencil during the experiment. So here we should write it P, Q, R equals to 200 grams. Like that, we can repeat this experiment for weight of the stone in air and weight of the stone in water for verifying the volume of the volume and density of the given stone. Our next observation, fourth observation, is instead of R we are taking one stone. So for observing the Y shape here, we can adjust these two weights. Suppose for Y shape it is not suitable, means we can add more 50 grams also both the sides. But these weights should not touch the drawing board. Once again, we can take it here. You know the P value, we know the Q value, and we don't know about this two. Same as usual, we can take two dots along with P with the help of the shape, and this is the along the R, and this is the along the Q. So here we can write it P equals to Q equals to 100 grams, but R equals to question mark. At the same time, we should write it. This is the weight of the stone in A. This is the weight of the stone in A. Then our next observation is weight of the stone in A. This stone is completely we dip in water. This P value is 100 grams because two strips are there, and Q value is also two strips. Along the R side we can take 2 points, along the Q side we are taking 2 points, and along the P side also we are taking 2 points. Just with the help of this pencil we have to take two dots along the R, two dots along the P, and two dots along this one, and we put the same position also. But here we can write it P equals to Q equals to 100 grams, R equals to question mark. Clearly we should mention this is the weight of the stone in water. Weight of the stone in water. So our first observation is PQR values are 100 grams. Second observation is 150, 150 grams. Then third one is 200 grams. Fourth one is the weight of the stone in air. And fifth one is the weight of the stone in water. So without parallax error, straight end we have to take these readings. Later we can draw that how to verify the parallelogram, how to verify the triangle, then how to find out the weight of the stone in air, and how to find out the weight of the stone in water. How to trace out the Y shape. Tracing out the Y shape, we can go through the how to verify the parallelogram and how to verify the triangle. Here we can trace out this Y shape with the help of the set square. This is the R bar. Just we can take it R here. This is P and this is Q. Already we have written what is P, what is Q, and what is R. Then for verification of the triangle, we can take the parallel to this one. Just we can extend this one like this. This is parallel to, suppose we are taking this is O, A, this is parallel to this one. Then already this is parallel to Q bar. This is the Q and this is the P, and here parallel to R bar we can take it. See, this is parallel to R bar, like this we can take with the help of the support of the set square. Move this one, see, like this. With the help of one set square we can move this one. Just we have to draw the parallel to this R. Move this one slowly like this. See, this is the parallel to this one. After adjusting we should move, and this is the triangle. Now parallel to P bar is the small p we are taking. Then parallel to Q we are taking the small q. Then parallel to this one is the R. This is in opposite direction. See, two sides are representing P and Q. Resultant of this one is showing the reverse of this one. Then we can go for second one also. Trace out the Y shape. We can trace out the Y shape. First we can go through the R. Like this we have to trace out Y shape. With the help of the pencil only we are doing all this. After this we can go for the triangle. See, already you know these two. Just we have to draw the parallel to this one. With the help of the set square we have to go through the parallel to this one. Then we should draw the, see, like this. Move this one. We have to draw the parallel this one. Then triangle is complete. How triangle is completed? P bar, Q bar, and R bar. One formula is there, I say to you later after measuring this readings. Then small capital P by small p, capital Q by small q, capital R by small r equals to constant. Then triangle is verified. Then how to trace out the Y shape? One by one I am showing. Look here. See, we have to trace out the Y shape with the help of these dots, whatever we have taken, then we can draw this one. Later we should draw the parallel for P bar, Q bar, R bar. P and Q already is there, means just we can draw the parallel to this R bar with the help of the set square. See, now this is parallel to this one, and move this one like that. We can take the parallel to this one, it will give the triangle. Parallel to P bar is the small p, and this is the small q, and resultant of this one is the opposite direction, this is R. So for all five observations we can trace out the Y shape, and we have to draw the triangle. See, here also we have to trace out the Y shape, and this is also triangular we are taking first. Then already parallel to P is over, parallel to Q is over. Now we can draw the parallel to this one. See, first we are keeping this, with the help of this one we can move this. This is the parallel to R. Then we can go for other observation. So one is over, two is over, and the last one is, this is the trace out the Y shape. We can trace out the Y shape. Then we can go through the triangle. Just we have to draw the generally P bar, Q bar, R bar parallel to that line, means it gives that. But already parallel to P bar is there, parallel to Q bar is there. Just we can take the parallel to R bar, then easily we should complete the. Anyway, you should have to draw that parallel, that parallel line. See, now you should move this one. Now with the help of the scale we can measure this. Already you know this is capital P, parallel to this P is the small p. So measure with the help of the scale, we have to write the P value, Q value, R value. See, here P value is 4 centimeters, then Q value is also 4 centimeters, and here R also we are measuring. This is the R, this is also 4 centimeters. So P, Q, R, all are 4 centimeters, 4 centimeters. Then how to verify the, how to verify the triangle? See, capital P by small p, capital Q by small p, small q, capital R by small r equals to constant. See, P, Q, R all are same. Here also small p, small q, small r all are same. So triangle is verified. Second one, 100 grams also. We can verify, is it following the, is it triangular or not, we have to take it. See, small p value is how much, small q is how much, and small r is how much. Look, this is the 5 centimeters. P equals to 5. Then q equals to 5 centimeters. R is also, we have to check. Then only we can verify the triangular. This is also 5 centimeters. So P, Q, R equals to capital letters are the 200 grams. And small p, small q, small r equals to 5 centimeters. So p by p equals to q by q equals to r by r. All are same, means triangular is verified. See, for second case also, triangular is verified. 100 grams is over, previous 100 grams is over, then 200 grams is over. Then we can go through the 150 grams. See, here small p is how much? This is 4 centimeters, and small q is also like 4.2 centimeters, nothing will happen, and r is 4 centimeters. So we can take it, p, small q, small r is how much? 4 centimeters. So here also triangular is verified. So here we find this, what is the triangular, two weights are representing two sides of the triangle, then the resultant is representing the third side of the triangle, that is the triangular. And we verified with the help of 100 grams, first observation, second observation, third observation. But our fourth observation is weight of the stone in air. For weight of the stone in air, how to find out the weight? Look here, here small p equals to, small p equals to 5.5 centimeters, and small q equals to, parallel to this one, this is also 5.5, 5.5 centimeters. R is nothing but weight of the stone. See, just now we know that P by P equals to instead of R by R. R is the weight of the stone in A. Here P is 5.5 and capital P is how many grams? 100 grams. Then R equals to, we know that we don't know about this, instead of R we are taking this weight of the stone in that one. But small r is this one, we can take the distance from here to here. This is a 4 centimeters. Then weight of the stone in where we are taking W1 equals to 400 into 5.5. So 55 into 4. What is this weight? This is 20, 22, 220 grams. 220 grams. Like that we can find out the weight of the stone in A. Then we can go for the weight of the stone in water also. Here what happens? Same thing with the help of P by P. Capital P is how much? 100. Small p is how much parallel to this one? See, this is 5. Instead of R, we are taking weight of the stone in water, W2 divided by small r is how much? This is 3. So, W2 equals to 300 by 5. 60 grams. Weight of the stone in air is 150 grams and weight of the stone in water is 60. To discuss about how to draw the parallelogram. Here first one is PQR equals to 100 grams. Each one we are taking this for 1 centimeter each 50 grams. So with the help of protractor we have to take the 4 centimeters because this is 200. Each 50 grams we are taking 1 centimeter. This length is the 4 centimeters. So at equilibrium position at O we are taking this and draw this one curve like this, and this side also 200 means here. Then we can go through this like this. See, if angle OCD is 180 degrees and OA equals to OB equals to OA equals to OB equals to OC, you can say parallelogram law is verified. Parallelogram law is verified. Like this we have to draw. Then with the help of this scale we can join this one. This is OA and this is OB and this is OC. Then parallelogram law is verified. Then our next thing is here weight of the stone in air 100 grams is there. So for this we are taking 2 centimeters. 2 centimeters here, 2 centimeters. We can draw the curve here from O. See, like this we have to draw the curve. This is O, this is A and this is B. Then how to take the C? Look here, we have to draw the C. Like this, we can draw the curve from this. Then our parallelogram law is verified. Now angle O, C, D. All are showing this is 180 grams means 180 degrees, sorry. That is the parallelogram law is verified. Same thing we can repeat for all 5 readings and you can find out the weight of the stone in air and weight of the stone in water. Thank you, everyone. Already we have traced out the Y shape from the concurrent forces experiment. 100 grams, 150 grams, 200 grams. We can make the table like this. See, capital P, Q, R in terms of grams. OA, OB. OA is just we can take, suppose it is 100 each 50 meters we are taking. 50 grams we are taking 1 centimeter. If it is 100 grams, no, we can make 2 centimeters. 2 centimeters. Then you can make curve. If angle C, OD is 180 degrees, you can say that parallelogram law is verified. Like that, we can do this one for 3 observations. For this we can make, finally we have to show that parallelogram law is verified. What is parallelogram law? These two are representing 2 adjacent sides of the parallelogram. then the resultant is diagonal passing through the origin. Like that, we can verify the triangulum. In this case also, P, Q are in terms of the grams. Small p, small q, small r are the distances. Already I have shown that. Then how to verify the triangle? If p by p equals to q by q equals to r by r. See, last three readings are same. You can say triangle is verified. Then two more things are there. Weight of the stone in air and weight of the stone in water. Weight of the stone in air from the parallelogram. See, this is the OC. This is the OC. OC into scale. 4.5 into scale is the 50. We are getting 225 grams. From the triangle, we know that already this is 220 grams. So approximately we are getting same. Like the W to weight of the stone in water is OC into scale. Here OC is 1.5. From these observations, OC is 1.5 into 50, 75 grams. Then how to find out the relative density of the stone? W1 by W1 minus W2. W1 is the weight of the stone in air. W2 is the weight of the stone in water. After simplifications, we got 1.5. All this is from parallelogram law of addition of vectors. But from the triangle also, we got it 1.35, approximately 1.4. So, thank you everyone.